Oh, to Connecticut and Jay Manuel, and not a moment too soon, talking about America's Next Top Model, and has it inspired a book that is behind it, but it's called The Meltdown. Jay, nice to have you here. Good to see you again. And our crew has remarked, you have the best facial hair they have ever seen. Have you been dealing with the facial hair a lot during quarantine?
Well, you know, when I started writing, actually, I grew my beard, and I'd never grown a beard before, so I decided it sticks. It fits with the whole author vibe, so, yeah.
All right, now looking at the cover behind you, are you the person in the black suit coat with the tie, and is that Tyra Banks with the long flowing hair?
It is not. The person on the cover is actually Pablo Michaels, and the supermodel standing next to him is Keisha Cash. My book is a complete work of fiction. It is inspired by my time on America's Next Top Model, but again, this is a work of fiction, and I really wanted to explore some really common themes and tropes within the entertainment industry, like what is the cost of fame? How does the entertainment industry deal with this abuse of power issue that we're seeing run throughout the industry? But then also, how does the industry deal with intersectionality and Black women's identity? So that this is a laugh out loud, fun piece of satire, but at the same time, there is a gravitas to this piece with some core themes that we're really talking about today in 2020.
One thing that I've read that you have said, which I thought was really, really interesting, and I tell you what, you're not the first person to say this, television is fantastic, but it comes and goes. A book, something you can physically, tangibly hold in your hand, I think is a different animal entirely. You say you're more proud of this than anything you've ever done.
Yes, you know, I dug into the work myself. I first kind of arced out the entire story. I built these character studies. I interviewed two different psychologists to help me tell this complex story with this unique cast of characters. And then at the end of the day, I did the work myself. So I did not have a ghostwriter. It was a profoundly incredible journey for me. I got to know myself in a new way. You know, writing is a very isolating process. But it was the most fulfilling thing I've ever really done and achieved.
All right, let us spill tea galore. You tell me, you worked with Tyra for years. She's obviously had enormous success, this new appointment with Dancing with the Stars. How do you think she will fare there?
Well, I think Tyra's going to do what she always does. She's going to bring all of her energy to the table. She's an amazing host. She's going to bring you all of the drama like you're seeing there on screen. And I think it's going to be a lot of fun. I think definitely all the judges and the contestants will probably have a fierce runway walk at the end of the season. But I think Tyra's going to do what she always does, which is bring her to the table and bring all this energy.
All right. There's a discussion we're having with regard to Ellen DeGeneres that's been going on for the last several weeks, that there's a distinction between people we watch on TV and we feel we know them from TV and what they're like in real life. Do you think, based on your America's Next Top Model family, there was a distinction between the Tyra or the Miss J or whomever, what they were like on camera and what they were like in real life?
I think for the most part, everybody was themselves on camera. And I think that's what made the show have its magic out of the gate. And we watched that show grow. We grew together. And then things did start to shift. And you know, it was a grueling schedule. We were taping two cycles every year. We worked 7 days a week. That was in physical production. You had pre and post production. So, you know, it was definitely a grind. And I think people had to start conserving their energy when they were on camera versus off. And, you know, my job was always to work with the girls. I spent probably the longest time with them on a day-to-day basis. And my job was to make sure that they could put their best foot forward. So, you know, it was definitely a grueling schedule, but amazing to be part of such an incredible franchise that became a global phenomenon.
I think my two favorite alums are Adriana Curry and Annalee Tipton. And this is another debate we have all the time. Do you think, and I don't mean to be so cut and dry, people have it or they don't, or can talent be developed?
I think talent can be developed, but when it comes to models, especially when you're looking for someone who can command the presence of a room or a red carpet, that's something that you're looking for when they walk in the room. And you can develop that talent further, but definitely you're looking for that it factor.
All right, having had the success, and by the way, The Meltdown is selling like hotcakes, so congratulations to you. Does it make
Thank you
want to go back to the keyboard or the longhand and write another book?
Well, I did type it, and I actually have started working on book two. I actually have another book that has nothing to do with this world, but I definitely know where this story, in terms of the meltdown and where it continues with these characters, it was definitely a lot of fun, and I'm so excited that I have, you know, even today, you know, in this virtual world with this pandemic, we're doing a live signing with Premier Collectibles, who offers autographed copies that people can just click, buy, and they ship all around the world. So we'll be live on my Facebook later on, and all the details are on my Instagram and Facebook.
All right, so livesigning.com is the website. Jay's Instagram or Facebook for that live virtual book signing. Jay, nice to see you this morning. Thanks so much. Thank you. I thought it was very interesting, you guys, how Jay's earbuds even match the totality of his outfit.
Very
sharp. A sharp and stylish guy.
Yeah.